Cell phones are unlikely to be given the boot from New Zealand schools anytime soon, according to the government. It comes as another Australian state has banned their use in both the classroom and the playground. Here's Australia correspondent Andrew McFarlane.
It may be close to the end of the first term.
So you've got 4 days to go and then Easter holidays, all right?
But come October in New South Wales, all public schools will look like this one, a phone no-go zone.
This will affect over 400 schools across the states. Upward of 320,000 students will be caught up in this ban.
Mobile devices are already banned in primary schools, and now high schools will follow suit under rules brought in by the new state premier, all in an effort to curb distractions for students and hopefully improve learning outcomes.
We get to learn more about other people around us and our community and not just on our phones all the time.
When the ban comes into force later this year, it'll be up to individual primary and high schools to make a call on how it's enforced. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. Phones can simply be locked away in lockers or zipped up in school bags.
Some New Zealand schools, like Hillmorton and Christchurch, have taken similar steps.
The immediate effect in classrooms was huge in that students weren't distracted at all. They were concentrating on their devices, on their lessons, not on their phones.
So does the Education Minister think a nationwide ban is needed?
Personally, as someone that was a teacher, no.
Jan Tinetti thinks they're a useful tool and it's up to individual schools.
You've got something that could potentially be the best and most important form of technology that sits in a kid's pocket, but what schools should be looking at and doing is making certain that kids are being kept safe.
So, unlikely the phones are going anywhere in New Zealand classrooms, as our Australian counterparts give them the boot. Andrew McFarlane, One News, Sydney.